Good morning all. So I hope that all of you have gone through the preliminaries which were uploaded in the last classes. So today we will see few more basic topics, and after that we will move on to the next way of solving the differential system of differential equations. So we will see few more basic topics. So in today's class we will look at linear independence and dependence. So when you take a vector, so there were two types of vectors. So one was a constant vector. So a constant vector is a vector in which, say, the entries are constant. So if you take a vector of this form, so that is a constant vector. If I am taking a vector like this, so e raised to t, e raised to 2t and e raised to 3t. So here the components of the vector, they are real functions. So this was called a vector function. So you can have a vector which is involving constants and a vector which is involving real functions. Now in today's class we will look at if you are given a set of vectors, so how do you say that they are linearly independent or linearly dependent? Okay. So we'll see a few basic theorems. Ningal already padichittulla theorems aanu. So we'll just state those theorems. So the first theorem is, so this is a theorem you have studied in matrices. So a system of n homogeneous equations linear algebraic equations in n unknowns . So that is basically the equation of the form Ax equal to 0. So this is, so x is x1, x2, etc. xn. So this is n homogeneous. So you have total n equations. So they are linear algebraic equation in n unknowns, which are x1, x2, etc. xn. So this has a non-trivial solution. If and only if the determinant of coefficients of the system is equal to 0. So the first theorem states that, so if you have a homogeneous system of the form Ax equal to 0, then obviously x equal to 0 is a trivial solution, and the non-trivial solution will exist provided determinant of A is equal to 0. So it has a non-trivial solution if and only if determinant of A is equal to 0. And the next theorem is on the solution of when you have a system which is not homogeneous. So if you have a system of the form Ax equal to B. So a system of n linear equations, so n linear algebraic equations in n unknowns has a unique solution if and only if the determinant of coefficient matrix, that must be not equal to 0. So determinant of coefficient matrix is unequal to 0. So if you have a system of the form Ax equal to B, then you have a unique solution x if and only if the determinant of a is not equal to 0 and the solution is given by a inverse b. So there a is the inverse of this matrix. Now using this, so let us give conditions for checking linear independence and linear dependence. So let us define when are a constant vector said to be linearly dependent and linearly independent. So let us see the definition. So let us consider constant vectors. So a set of m constant vectors v1, v2, etc., vm is linearly independent. Linearly dependent if there exist a set of m numbers c1, c2, etc., cm, not all zero, such that, so when you take c1 v1 plus c2 v2 plus c3 v3 plus etc. cm vm is equal to 0. So when you solve for the equation c1 v1 plus c2 v2 plus etc. cm vm equal to 0, if not all the ci's are equal to 0, the vectors are said to be linearly independent, and if all ci's are equal to 0, they are linearly independent. So that is a condition for the vectors v1, v2, etc., vm to be linearly independent and linearly dependent. And so those are the two conditions. And now let us see an example of checking the linear independence or linear dependence. So suppose you are given the set of three vectors v1, v2, v3. So you have v1 equal to the vector 1, 1, 1. Then v2 is the vector minus 1, 2, 0. And suppose v3 is a vector 0, 2, 1. So we need to write down the equation c1 v1 plus c2 v2 plus c3 v3 equal to 0. So that gives c1 1 1 1 plus c2 minus 1 2 0 plus c3 0 2 1 equal to 0. So you will get the equation in the form. The first components equate here. The c1 minus c2. So third term 0 out. Equal to 0 varum. Then c1 plus 2c2 plus 2c3 equal to 0. Then c1 plus c3 equal to 0. We have seen in the first theorem this is a homogeneous system of equation. So it has a non-trivial solution when determinant is equal to 0. So non-trivial solution exist if determinant of A is equal to 0. So let us calculate the determinant. Our aim is to check whether these solutions are independent or not. Upon c1, c2, c3 value and oriented. Ellam 0 ano, adho non-zero values. So let us look whether it has a non-trivial solution or not. So we need to find the determinant 1 minus 1, 0, then 1, 2, 2. 1 0 1. So determinant will be, you will get 1 into 2, then minus 1 into 1 minus 2 it up again, minus 1. So that will be 2 minus 1, so which is not equal to 0. So therefore determinant of A is not equal to 0. So determinant of A is not equal to 0. That implies C1 equal to, all you have only the trivial solution. C1 equal to C2 equal to C3 equal to 0. So therefore the vectors V1, V2, V3 are linearly independent. So that is how you check whether the solutions are linearly independent or linearly dependent. So corresponding coefficient matrix the determinant kandupidikka. So if determinant is equal to 0, they will be independent, and if the determinant is not equal to 0, they will be dependent. Okay. Now similarly you can define the linear independence and dependence for vector functions. Ippo nammal kandathu constant vectors aanu. Now you can have vectors involved in real functions. So let us give the definition for that also. Again, the definition is the same. Linear independence and dependence define cheyuna same detail thanneyana. So the set of M vector functions phi 1, phi 2, etc. phi m is linearly dependent on an interval a less than or equal to d less than or equal to b if there exist a set of m numbers, say c1, c2, etc. cm not all zero, such that c1 phi 1 plus c2 phi 2 plus etc. cm phi m is equal to 0. So again the same condition. So you are having vector functions phi 1, phi 2, phi m. So these are vectors where the components are going to be functions. Now they will be linearly independent if there exist the numbers constant c1, c2, cm, which are all so all of them must not be 0, such that c1 phi 1 plus c2 phi 2 plus etc. cm phi m is equal to 0. Now if all CIs are equal to 0, then in that case, then the vector functions, so phi 1, phi 2, etc. phi m are linearly independent. So that's how we define the linear independence and linear dependence of vector functions. So I think we'll stop with this for today. So next class we'll see few examples.